On a recent visit to the Sunland Visitor Center near Eloy, I met an interesting man that's working on a project that many of you may not know about. His name is Dick Myers, and he's dedicating himself to preserving the history of the Eloy Toltec area by restoring the old schoolhouse and the adjacent buildings.
The school, actually there was two parts. Let's go back to the beginning. The Toltec School District was founded in 1913, was set aside as a school district, and 1926 Frank Shedd donated the 1.73 acres to the school district to build a schoolhouse. And then in 1927 or so, they started construction and opened up in the fall of 1928 with the first two buildings that were wooden structures. The African-American school was set to the south part, and the original school, the wooden school was 1 through 8, was immediately south of the building we're in now, which was built in 1930. The construction people are contractor was Hogan and Farmer, and they started, we found that on the door frames and a couple of other wood pieces that's in the structure of the building. So we now have our contractor who built the structure, as far as we know, and trying to complete the renovation as best we can to turn it back to near original condition to start off with and turn it into a museum.
The first project he tackled was restoring the African-American schoolhouse. In 1954, the case of Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka ended segregation in the United States. Up until that time, African-American children were educated separate from children of other races. This landmark Supreme Court case paved the way for integration and was a major victory of the civil rights movement. Segregation is an unfortunate part of American history. That's why preserving historical buildings like this is so important, because if we cannot remember the past, we are doomed to repeat it.
Eloy itself and Toltec here was, Eloy had a population around 1,500 year-round, and it would balloon to over 15,000 in this area in a month. And that started in September and usually run through January, February, and the migrant workers that came to pick cotton and harvest the crops would move on to other jobs and follow the crops and do harvesting elsewhere. Well, from what we gather, they had an average attendance of around 45 students, and then it would go to over 200 to 250 students in that time period from September to January, February. And it was just due primarily to the migrant workers' influx of people coming to harvest the crops. Primarily, it's a solid structure. It's the architecture. It's unique. It's a sound building, and it's really, we'd like to turn it into a museum for the history of Pinal County, the cotton farming, and history of the cotton farming in Pinal County is our theme. Hopefully, we can raise the funding to purchase air conditioners and finish up the sheetrock and the painting and stuff, which is primarily about all we lack. Getting the building completely functional again. The water, the plumbing is almost complete. So it's been a work, kind of a long project. We started in 2004 and there it is 2015, but we're making progress every day and continue to have the support from the community and continue to move along with the project. Hopefully money comes in, we'll get it done. Well, right now we've applied for a grant from the Gila River to for $25,000 to buy 2 5-ton air conditioners. If we don't get that grant, we'll definitely need the money to purchase those two units. We're finishing up the electrical in the building and bringing it up to code. We need to get the sheetrock up on the ceiling and then primarily prime it and paint it, the entire structure inside, and should replace several of the window panes that are have the old plexiglass, which is discolored and out of place, but we want to put in new glass or historically correct glass if we can find it, and repair the window frames. We have four window frames that need repaired. We have half of those done and trying to find the structural steel that the windows, metal sash windows are made out of. We can hopefully get it back done to original condition. Yeah, the biggest thing that we need is a financial support from the community in the way of cash donation so that we can continue to purchase the things that are necessary to complete the project. We need curtains and drapes. We need to replace the glass, like I said earlier. We also have sheetrock to purchase, and the wiring's almost complete. We're over 50% complete with the wiring right now as we stand. The air conditioned units are going to be the biggest expense, and if we don't receive a grant, then we'll have to have a lot more money from the public or the support of the community to get that part of it purchased and done. It's been a great support we've had from the community. We could always use more. My concern is once that we get the thing open, is keeping it open, because then you start having payroll, or you may have you're going to have your utility bills and all of those. Insurance is $3,000 a year right now, and that takes a big expense or a chunk of change out of the budget. So it just is a never-ending process when you're getting things ready to open. You can donate through our website to the Santa Cruz Valley Historic Museum, P.O. Box 280, Arizona City, 85123. And we have the website, which is scvhmuseum.org. And you can see the history of the building and see the progress. We're trying to post some pictures as to what it looked like when we started and what we have completed. And my phone number, if anybody wants to contact me direct, is 520-421-0696 is my home phone. My cell phone is 520-840-1041. And if you need any help or your questions we can answer, we'd be glad to do that. Just give us a call or send an email to our website, and somebody will get back with them and make sure that we answer all the questions and how our museum operates or going to operate, whatever they need to ask, we can hopefully give them an answer.
Dick also hosts an annual fundraiser, a dinner dance held each fall. There's raffles, silent auctions, of course dinner and dancing, lots of great music, and a whole lot of fun. For information on how to purchase tickets, visit scvhmuseum.org or just give Dick a call at 520-421-0696 or 520-840-1041. Won't you please help? Your financial donations or donations of time and materials are greatly appreciated. Together, we can restore this old schoolhouse to its former glory and help preserve a part of Eloy Toltec history.